Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos and today we're going to discuss about retargeting in 2023. We hear so much about it, especially after the launch of Advantage Plus campaigns, but which is the truth? So, just so you know what you're going to see on this video. First of all, we're going to discuss about the different ways of doing retargeting. Secondly, we're going to discuss about the ratio between cold funnel and retargeting, what percentages. Third thing that we're going to see is that I'm going to take you on my PC, show you how to create these custom audiences if you don't know how to do it. Fourth thing, we're going to discuss a little bit about catalog retargeting, not how to create a catalog, obviously, you can create it easily with your Shopify store or whatever, but how you run ads with catalog and how to run conversion ads with retargeting audiences, and also we're going to discuss a little bit about if you need retargeting and when you should start breaking down your funnel more if you're having good results with your retargeting. That's all. Some things first about retargeting. What is retargeting? Retargeting is when we actually create custom audiences, which I'm going to show you in a little bit on how to do it. And then we take these custom audiences and we use them in order to retarget all the people that they have been inside our funnel or funnels. Why is this super effective? Because these are people that they have been to our funnel, they know our site, they know our products, maybe they didn't buy, maybe they bought in the past and you have to remind them, or maybe they didn't buy and they need a reminder just so that you can convince them to buy, because not everybody is an impulsive buyer, they want to think of it. And because of that, retargeting is super effective, but there's one thing. There are a lot of people that they think that you should not do retargeting because Facebook is all about new clients. I disagree with that. I think that e-commerce in general and every business that you have, it really depends on repeated customers, and repeated customers are fueling data your pixel so that it can have more data about the ideal avatar of your clients so that it can target more efficiently. On the other hand, we have the people that they say that Facebook is stealing sales of retargeting on cold funnel. And of course, this discussion is bigger and bigger after the introduction of Advantage Plus, which we cannot exclude audiences. And let me tell you that even on my cold traffic ads, when I exclude people that they have been to the funnel in the past or whatever, the results are lesser. So we know that, and I know it because I'm using on some of the ads actual URLs that I can measure if the sales are coming from Facebook or if they are just repeated customers that Facebook is stealing the sales from. First of all, if you are a small business, you should not worry about that, because these things are happening in a bigger scale with big accounts and bigger spends. Secondly, yes, it happens. And yes, I agree with you. It's a little bit annoying that Facebook is stealing the sales on the cold traffic ads, but there are two things. You have a Facebook pixel and you're targeting a cold traffic funnel. You're targeting a cold traffic audience. Who do you think that is going to try to target first? The people that it thinks that they're going to convert. Well, in bigger scale, some of these people are going to be inside your retargeting audience. Second thing, does it matter if it's going to steal one sale from your retargeting or your email marketing or from your SMS marketing? If this sale comes and it's going to help the ad to optimize and find then another sale that it wouldn't come without this data. So in other words, I'm trying to say that if this data is being used in order to find new customers and in order to have health on the account and more sales coming, so let it be, let it steal the sales, it's totally fine. So the case is that I hear some people that I hear and I see at accounts that they do two mistakes. Mistake number one is that they go and they just exclude all of their past, even visitors, from their cold traffic ads because they think about having new traffic all the time. Let me tell you that this is going to be devastating for your results for the reason that I mentioned before. The fact that you're getting some data that is going to help you find other data. It's a game of data at the end of the day. So whenever they do that on the other accounts, I can see that the results are very bad. Second thing is that I see now a new trend that there are people that they say zero retargeting, because anyway, your Facebook ads are going to do all of the retargeting that they need to do within your cold traffic audience. I think that this is total BS. Also, I think that this is a generalization, and there are completely different businesses that they are really dependent on the repeat customers, and there are really different businesses that they are different niches and you need to do retarget. what you need to take care and what you should look is actually the percentages that you do. For example, one standard ratio in the market is 70% cold, 30% retargeting. If you go to higher budgets, you cannot have this 70-30%. Imagine having 70k spent and 30k retargeting. I think it's a lot, spending 1k per day on retargeting alone. So what we are doing is that the more we increase the budgets and the more we increase the spend on the ad accounts, the less we are going to actually spend on retargeting and the percentage is dropping. Secondly, we analyze the company and we see, do they need repeated customers? Is this an item that people are going to buy once and stuff? So you analyze and you see if they need it or not. And then of course you have cases of retargeting that you need to do. For example, there are audiences like the people who engage with your Facebook and Instagram that even if they have engaged, because every ad that you do is considered a post. So the people who are engaging with it, even if they haven't clicked to go into your site, maybe they have never been to your site, but you're not actually retargeting them. Also, if you exclude them from other funnels, it's like somebody has done the mistake of watching your video, never clicked, so he engaged with your ad, and then you go and you just exclude him from every other ad that you're doing. He's never going to convert. So there are ways, and I think that as people that we do Facebook ads, do I have accounts that I'm not doing retargeting? The answer is yes. And I understand the concept for some ad accounts, but please, when you are watching the information on these videos, please be careful, because there are so many people that they're saying their experiences, but maybe they're sharing their experience with one or two other accounts that they are working like this. It doesn't mean that we should generalize everything and say, no, you don't need retargeting at all. Maybe in your business, you do need retargeting. The idea is that you should work with someone that you trust, and you should not feel like this person is using retargeting in order to inflate the results that you are having on the ad account so that he's going to take X amount of money from a cooperation that you are having with revenue sharing, for example. You need to have a very clear communication with the person that you are working with so that you don't have these kind of problems. The last thing that I want to mention over here is that retargeting is necessary, in my opinion, in several cases, in several other accounts. In the other accounts that I'm not doing it, I'm doing it not because the owner is telling me not to do it, but I'm doing it because I feel like it's not needed over there because we are covering it with another way. Okay, so as I said, let's go into my PC so that I can show you the different audiences that you can use and the different structure that you can have, and a little so that you can see also in some actual accounts how much money am I actually spending between other accounts in just retargeting, so that you can get an idea. And we're on this account. This account operates in the United States. In the last 7 days in this account, we are spending 35K, let's say. Okay, yesterday alone, we spent close to 6K. Okay, so I'm in the process of scaling this account anyway. So what I want to show you is actually really nice, because if in the last 7 days I'm having 6.34 and yesterday I'm having 6.31, it means that I will be fine with the scaling. What I want to show you is this. My retargeting is this campaign, guys, okay? It's only this campaign. I'm also not a person that I'm really focusing on retargeting. I really like cold traffic ads, and I'm trying to fix the cold traffic, because the cold traffic is going to fuel all of your efforts on retargeting. The point is not to have an account which is just doing retargeting. It just is cannibalizing your audience all over again. So don't get me wrong when I say that you need retargeting. I'm saying that you need retargeting just to be there in a small percentage so that you're not leaving money on the table. This is my problem. I don't want you to leave any money on the table. This is why you should do also email marketing, SMS marketing, whatever you can do in order to get the sales. But as you can see over here, I'm just spending $400 per day on just retargeting. And everything else, the 5.5K here, it's all about having sales with cold traffic ads. Now you might say, why is your retargeting having less ROAS? Because I'm not doing a lot of retargeting, and retargeting sales are being stolen from cold traffic ads. Let me tell you also that this company is very active on email marketing, SMS marketing, so a lot of sales are getting go from there. We have Google Ads, so everything is stealing everything, but it's fine. It's an ecosystem. Let's go in another account maybe, or this one, And over here we can see that this is a United Kingdom account, for example, okay? In the last 7 days, we're having 20K spent, 5.7 ROAS, and the retargeting that we are having over here is just $300 that we're spending per day. And yesterday, here we have exactly the opposite. We have better results on retargeting. Actually, the results on retargeting are pretty decent here. And this is what is happening, guys, on the smaller budgets. So on most accounts, when we have smaller budgets, we can see that the retargeting is the one that is doing better and the call traffic is doing a little bit less, which is fine because it's helping you to compensate for some of your testing and everything. As soon as you scale, you spend less money on retargeting and you have less ROAS, you might have more ROAS in some of your call traffic ads because your call traffic ads are stealing the sales from retargeting. This is how we know that Facebook is stealing sales on retargeting, because we can see it on bigger accounts. In smaller accounts, it's not something that you can observe. You can observe it only on bigger accounts with bigger numbers. By just searching my accounts, I found something else that I wanted to show you. A lot of people are just talking about the Advantage Plus and how it's stealing sales from retargeting, and I can tell you that this is a fact. Look, for example, in this account. This is an account that I showed in my previous video explaining how it's focusing everything on Advantage Plus. As I told you, the break-even ROAS on this one is 1.8, 2.27 on this month. And as you can see, the retargeting, that I'm spending almost nothing over here. I'm spending most on my cold 50 and another 20. We are on 70, let's say. And the spending on this account is almost 3K, 2.5K. Okay, so we have 2.5K spending daily on this account. I think I scaled today with this campaign for another 500, so it's going to be 3K. This is why I mentioned 3K. So let me see actually. Yes. So the situation is that over here you can see that they have kind of the same ROAS as we have on the call traffic ads. And this is happening. Again, here it's not a very big account, but we're not seeing the situation that we see in this account, actually, that we are having 7.9 ROAS on retargeting and we have less on the other call traffic. We can see that all of the ads here, they actually operate with 2 ROAS, okay, even on retargeting and stuff. What does this mean? That in order for us to get higher ROAS on retargeting, either we have to lower the spend or we should not do retargeting at all, because Advantage Plus has no exclusions or anything and it's taking also a lot of sales from retargeting. We all know that, we have seen it, we have observed it. We think also this is one of the reasons that Advantage Plus is super successful. Let me show you another one, a smaller one, and then we will go to show you how to create your different audiences. Okay, so I found an ideal account to show you another case now. So we discussed earlier and I told you that I don't believe that every business is actually the same. We are having different businesses that they have different needs. Over here, you can see that we have more spending. We have 90 per day. We are going to fix that now because we are doing a scaling. But the last month, for example, here, we are having 60 spent on call traffic and 90 spent on retargeting, because this is how the business operates. It really operates with repeated customers and we need to do retargeting. This is coming from the owners and the way that they want to operate. And you can see here that most of the times it's like this. The structure used to be like this. In small accounts, it's still like this, but as you go to bigger accounts, you can see that this difference between the ROAS doesn't go like this. So most of the times we can see bottom of funnel having most of the ROAS. Here we can see that it has 6.05. And how do we do bottom of funnel? We create an audience of all visitors for the last 30 days and we exclude the people who purchased the last 30 days. Another way to do bottom of funnel is to do view content 30 days and do also add to cart 30 days, two custom audiences, and just exclude the people who purchased in the last 30 days. Let me discard the draft here. Okay. So over here, then we are having the middle of funnel. The middle of funnel is the long-term retargeting, as we used to call it. And what you can do here is you can come here and you can do, there are two ways of doing middle of funnel. Number one is coming here and doing people who engage with Instagram, people who engage with Facebook on the last 220 days. Don't ask me why I used 220 days. I don't know. I started using it some years ago and still use it. I don't know why 365 days don't go well for me and 220 days go well for me. I just use 220. I have no justification. Call me superstitious, call me whatever, it doesn't matter. Over here, we're having Instagram engages, 220 days, Facebook engages. Why is this important? And we can see also that as a middle of funnel, which is not bottom of funnel, which is last 30 days, it's middle of funnel. We can see that over here, we are actually having people who engaged with social media, so it's not so strong. Okay, so the ROAS that we are having here is 4.5, and then on our cold traffic ads, we are having 3.3. And for some people, this structure might not be appealing, but for this company, it's working very well because this is the nature of the company. Okay, we will have to adapt to whatever the company needs are. And the other thing that I want to mention here is that you can do also another middle of funnel retargeting that you can actually target all the people who have been into your funnel in the last 180 days. Now, there's always a misconception here from the people that they are saying, but if you do 180 days of website visitors, then you are overlapping your audience with bottom of funnel and middle of funnel. Well, they are right. But I think that it's not such a big, it doesn't make such a big difference. Now, if we talk about very small accounts, maybe yes. But if we talk about bigger accounts and stuff, you should not be bothered by it. Let me show you how to create some custom audiences over here. In order for you to create the custom audiences of the last 30 days that we were discussing, you go here to the website, you put the correct pixel over here, and you have the different options over here. So all website visitors, you put here the 30 days, you put the audience name, you name it website visitors, 30 days, and you go and you create it. Okay, so now it's going to be here. In order for you to come here, by the way, you need to come by the audiences, okay? Or you can find this one here through advertise. Now, when you are here, you can create more custom audiences that you can use. So we go again to the website, press next, and you can create. I will show you all of them. So you can create view content, add to cart, initiate checkout, purchase, add payment info. And there are two more that most people forget and you can also use. Is the people by time spent. It has the percentage 25, 10% and 5%. And here you're putting the days that you want. So this is the quality traffic audience, okay? This is the audience that it's actually stayed longer into your site. And another way of actually monitoring a little bit better traffic is that when you do view content and you refine it by aggregated value of 2 or 3. So let's think a hypothetical scenario over here that you're having a lot of items, 1,500, and people are buying different products into your store. In order for you to define the people that they are watching your collections, your different, this is very good for women's clothing, for example, okay? Think of it like this. Let's say that you are ASOS.com and you're having either a catalog or you're doing retargeting with some of your new collection. What do you want to do? You want to retarget people that they have seen more than one of your products. Why? When somebody goes into your site, when they land into your homepage, it's considered a page view. When they start watching your different things like a product, like a collection page or something, it's considered content view. So when somebody is watching item 1, item 2, item 3, another dress, another skirt, another this, another that, they are view content 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is going to continue and it means that they like your collection, they are watching more products. These are the people that maybe you want to segment in another retargeting and maybe retarget them with one of your new collections in order to see if they are going to buy. And you can play with this number, is greater than, let's say, 10 or 5. What I like to do for me, what I like to do is 2. Why? Because most of the times when we do ads, we send people to one landing page, which is going to be the product, and this is considered one view. If he sees another one, it means already for me that he is intrigued by something and he's watching more things into your site. So this is one thing. This is how you do for 30 days your bottom of funnel, which is view content add to cart 30 days, exclude people who purchased in the last 30 days. In order for you to do it, it's a very simple structure. You do an ABO or CBO campaign, it doesn't matter, just one ad set. So let's go here. If we go in the bottom of funnel, you can see that we are having website visitors 30 days, okay? You can put here also add to cart, for example, of 30 days, okay? You can put it here, okay? So all of that, you can do out of all website visitors 30 days and exclude people who purchase, or you can do last 30 days add to cart and view content and exclude the people who purchase. So visitors or that, this is the bottom funnel. Middle of funnel now is, it's having two ways. One way is you can actually use the social engagers, and I'm going to show you how to create now this audience. You come here and you press custom audience. You press on Instagram, for example, next. You pick the correct Instagram over here. You put 220 days and you have everyone who engages with this audience. And you are going to do the same over here for your Facebook page. Why is this important? As I said earlier in the video, everything that you do, it's considered a post. So whoever is engaging with your ads, it's considering with your page. So maybe they're engaging, but they're not clicking to go into your site. So if you don't retarget them as a middle of funnel, you're going to lose them. Another way to do middle of funnel is to do actually these custom audiences again over here, press next, and come here and do all of the audiences that we discussed, but put 180 days. What's the difference over here? That you are retargeting people, long-term customers, okay? So you are having people that they are going to, that they bought in the past or they had to cut or whatever. They are more than 30 days, so it's not your fresh audience. Maybe they don't even remember you and you're going to remind them. This is also a very good way for you if you have a new collection to actually retarget people that they have bought in the past or they have been there. Another thing that you can do is that you can create a custom audience with a customer list that you can upload if you have from Klaviyo or whatever and you just want to target them. Let me tell you that they are not as effective unless if they are super, super, super good and detailed and they have right emails and everything. Then we have the video, which is another way of retargeting. Basically, you are coming here and you put people who have seen 95 or 75% of the video and in the last 220 days, and you are coming here and you are picking, let's do it, you're picking next, and then you're choosing the videos that you want. It's better for you to pick videos that they have a lot of engagement, okay? When they have a lot of engagement, you're going to find a lot of people here. And the last thing that you can actually do, if you're doing lead generation, you can retarget people that they have done a lead form, and you can have the lead form over here that you're using. Anyone who opened but didn't submit, or who opened and submitted form. So you can create also custom audiences for all of you that you're doing lead generation, and you can also segment it to middle of funnel and bottom funnel based on the 30 days or 180 days. Don't forget that all of you that you're doing lead generation, you can also do Instagram and Facebook engagement custom audiences, so that you can retarget also the people that they have engaged with your ads, but they haven't clicked your form. One thing that we haven't touched is catalog. And in order to show you, we're going to go into this account. So catalog retargeting is when you create a campaign over here, you're going over here to sales, and you can see that we have catalog sales over here, okay? So you press sales, you press continue. Of course, we don't want Advantage Plus, you press continue. And here we're going to end up with the option of actually having a catalog. You turn it on, you pick the catalog, it's in your Commerce Manager. If you want to see your catalog and everything, you need to come to Commerce Manager. This is where it's located right now. It's very easy to create a catalog through your Shopify store, but let me tell you that I really don't use catalogs unless if I have a store which has several items. And the reason for that is because they are extremely buggy and they have a lot of issues and they always lose items and stuff and everything. I don't like them at all. Let me show you the structure and one or two things that I want to mention about the catalogs over here. So we go into this campaign. Also, I'm using a catalog only in bottom of funnel on the last 30 days. It's working also in middle of funnel. It's working also even on cold traffic, but I'm not using it. I don't like it. I just I just don't like catalogs because they are super buggy, okay? They have always problem. I always put a product set of in stock items because of course if you're having a lot of items you need to monitor the stocks and everything. As you can see here, we're having add to cart view count the last 30 days, and over here we are having no detailed everything open on retargeting. By the way, you should have open your targeting. You should not exclude demographics and everything because these are people that they have been into your funnel. One thing that I want to show you, which is last, is that you can do it like this. You can put a custom audiences here, or it has an inbuilt way that you can do here, this one, or the different options that it's giving you. Don't forget, guys, very, very important, that when you do that, you need to show more options here in order to see the location that you are targeting. Because a lot of times, this is set up to the default location of the ad account. So if your default location, for example, for me that I live in Greece, it's Greece, but I'm advertising in the United States, it's going to try to run it in Greece, and you will have zero spend into your catalog because it doesn't have anyone to target in Greece. So be careful with that when you do it like this. You can put here the options and everything. I think that's all. I think I explained everything on how I see retargeting. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions so that I can answer it. Don't start asking me about how to create catalogs. There are millions of videos to go there and watch. We are here for the more advanced stuff. So that's all I had for you about the retargeting on 2023. It's a little bit different from my previous video that I had on 22 or whenever, and I was talking about retargeting, and the thing that has changed is that retargeting was impacted a lot by all of the changes of iOS 14.5. Now we have the 28 days attribution coming back, so it's going to spark another discussion about how Facebook is stealing sales of 28 days, even if they're coming from other sources. Because right now, imagine that we have already this discussion on the 7 days attribution. Imagine going to the 28 days attribution and actually Facebook getting retargeting sales 28 days later from someone that has seen an ad, interacted with an ad, actually, because the view it's also going to be on one day. If you don't know what I'm talking about, anyway, it's for advanced people. So the other thing is that this is my view about 2023. It changed a little bit in terms of the percentages. Before the iOS, or on 2022, early 2022, we were doing bigger percentages on retargeting. What we have seen later is that Facebook actually was doing also retargeting on the cold traffic ads. So we limited the budget on our retargeting campaigns because we knew that some of those are going to end up in the cold traffic, which is even better in my opinion, okay? It's better for the retargeting sales to go on the cold traffic because it's going to help us get new clients. On the retargeting, it's just going to help us, you know, have some good ROAS. But if the retargeting sales are going on the cold traffic, this is a blessing for me, at least, and the way that I see it with data optimization. And this is where the people that they say that you should not do retargeting, they actually focus on. They focus on the fact that if you don't do retargeting, the sales are going to go on the cold traffic. But on the other hand, you should do retargeting because you will lose some sales in the process if you don't do it from the cold traffic ad, which their core job is not to do retargeting, but find cold traffic audiences. The fact that they're getting some sales there is just irrelevant to the actual results that you want to achieve with or without retargeting. That's all I had for you. If you want to learn more about Facebook ads, you can check my book or my free course or my paid course, which is updated with all of this information. You can check everything into my site, and don't forget that until we meet again, be creative and be consistent, guys.